हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स फील्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट सब्जेक्ट. इट इज़ द लॉ, दैट इज बिजनेस रेगुलेटरी फ्रेमवर्क. दिस सब्जेक्ट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ थर्ड ईयर बीकॉम्स सिलेबस. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सेकेंड लेसन, लॉ ऑफ पार्टनरशिप. This lesson, even though all students feel it is very difficult, we are learning this subject in very interesting manner. I, Dr. Rakeshwaram, welcome you all in my YouTube channel. So let's begin with the introduction of the law of partnership. So before starting the law of partnership, we must know the background of the topic. I think you all have studied forms of business organization in 11th and 12th standard in the subject OCM, that is Organization of Commerce and Management. In the same sense, in 12th standard, you have already learned the definition of partnership, because in accountancy you have studied final accounts of partnership firm in 12th standard. So there are various forms of business organizations that you can see in the market. The first form of business organization, it is a sole trading concern, sole trading company, or sole trading business, which is also called as proprietorship business. In sole trading organization, there is only one person is the owner of the business. It means minimum and maximum person, owner, partner, it is only one person. That is why it is called as a sole trading concern. Second form of business organization is the Hindu Undivided Family Business, HUF. This also you have studied. For HUF, it requires minimum two persons. One of the person is called as a karta, that you have already learned, and other members are called as a co-partners. There is no specific maximum number of persons is prescribed in the HUF law. First is the sole trading, second is the HUF, and third is the partnership firm. In partnership firm, minimum two persons are required and maximum 20 persons. We will see this in detail. But if the partnership firm business, it is of banking business, then maximum number of members allowed is 10. Third type of business, it is a cooperative society. In cooperative society, if you want to form the cooperative society, minimum number of members that required, it is 10. And on maximum number of members, there is no limit. And the last form of business organization that we usually see in the day-to-day life, it is a joint stock company. And according to the Indian Companies Act, New Companies Act 2013, we also permitted to form a one-person company. It means one person can also form a business. In case of one-person company, only one person is allowed. Only one person is allowed. There is no maximum number of members. In case of the private company, minimum number of members which is required to form a private limited company, it is 2, and maximum number of members, it is 200. prior to the Companies Act 2010-13, the limit for the private limited company, it was 50. In most of the books you will find 50, but it was prior to the Companies Act 2010-13. It means as per the Indian Companies Act 1956. And third type of the joint stock company, it is a public limited company wherein minimum number of members which are required, it is 7, and there is no limit on the maximum number of members. So these are the various forms of business organization, and today we are going to learn partnership firm, partnership law. In India, the Partnership Act is governed by the Indian Partnership Act 1932, which extends to the whole of India. This act came into force on 1st October 1932. So what is the eligibility? It means who can become a member of the partnership firm. A partnership agreement can be entered into between persons who are competent to contract as per the Indian Contract Act 1872. A partnership agreement can be entered into between persons who are competent to contract. It means those persons can become a partner of the partnership firm who are competent to contract. I think in the previous lesson, that is Indian Contract Act 1872, you have learned who are competent to contract. Major three conditions. Every person who is the age of majority, who has completed the age of 18 in India according to the law, and to which he is subject, and who is of sound mind, it means related to that particular contract, who is of sound mind, it means a person who is of sound mind, it means who can take his own decision, who is not unsound mind, who has not declared as unsound by the doctor or medical practitioner, and who is not disqualified from contracting by any law to which he is subject, can enter into the partnership. Not disqualified from contracting by any law. Suppose if a person has disqualified from doing contract by any law, then he is not eligible. It means any person who are competent to contract can enter into the partnership firm. And who are competent? Number one, who has attained the age of majority, who is of sound mind, and who is not disqualified from contracting by any law. Now come to the definition. Section 4 of the Indian Partnership Act defines partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. This definition, before completion of this video, you must learn by heart this definition. Partnership is the relationship between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. If this definition is given in the Indian Partnership Act, then how will you learn? there are so many methods of learning the definition learning. There are so many methods of learning. And if you want to learn the definition, I will suggest analysis and interpretation method. If you want to learn the any definition, then you have to make the analysis of the definition. So let's make the analysis of this definition. Partnership is the relationship between persons. Means there must be minimum two or more persons. Here I have already explained minimum 2 and maximum 20. In case of banking business, maximum 10 members are required. So the definition is partnership is the relationship between persons. Means what is partnership? It is a relationship. Whose relationship? Among the persons. Which persons? Who have agreed to share the profits of a business. Remember, in this definition, the word loss is not given. Who have agreed to share the profits of a business. It means every person who enter into the partnership business, he enters with the aim to earn the profit. That is why in the act the word losses is not given. In most some of the textbook I read, it is profits or losses, but the act doesn't specify losses. No person will enter into the partnership to sustain a loss. But even though in the definition the word profit is given, if the firm suffers a loss, it is also shared among the partners. See the definition, partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business. Carried on by all or any of them. Carried on. Carry on, carry on. It means who will carry on the business? Either by all the partners or any of them. For example, if there are four partners in the partnership business, A, B, C, D, then the firm may be carried on, the business may be carried on either by all, that is A, B, C, D, or any of them, A, B, or ABC or BC or AD. It means any of them, any of the partners can carry on the business. It means it will explain the person who contributes capital and as well as who take active participation into day-to-day management of the firm. He is known as acting partner. But some partner who contributes capital but doesn't take active participation into day-to-day business, then he is called as a sleeping partner or dormant partner. And the last term, it is a acting for all. What the definition says, partnership is the relationship between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business, carried on by all or any of them, acting for all. Here acting for all means, suppose there are four persons, A, B, C, D, again. A, he is a principal. It means every partner is a principal. Here A, B, C, D. Each and every person is the principal. Principal means main. Main. He is a principal. He is the owner of the business. He is the head of the business because he acts for himself, because he has contributed some capital. He is a principal because he acts for himself. And he is an agent of other partners because he simultaneously acts for the rest of the partners. He simultaneously acts for the rest of the partners. That is acting for all. It means in partnership firm, all partners A, B, C, D are the principal and agent of other. Principal and agent of others. So, I think the definition it is by heart you have learned. Partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. Now, please close your eyes and try to bring the definition before your eyes. Partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. That's it. So any definition in this way you can learn by heart by using the analysis and interpretation method. Analysis means you have to break the definition and you have to interpret yourself. Okay. Now see the another terms: partners, firm, and firm name. Who are partners? Persons who have entered into the partnership with one another are called individually partners. In this case, A, B, C, D, each person is called as a partner individually. And all persons, that is A, B, C, D, are collectively known as firm. And the name under which the business is carried on. For example, this business is carried on under the name of ABC Limited. I think you are remembering one company which was established by Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, ABC Limited, Amitabh Bachchan Corporation Limited. Now it was dissolved. So ABC, it is a firm name. Actually, it was a limited company, but just I am giving the example ABC. Okay, so partners are the persons who have entered into the partnership. They are individually called as partners. Collectively, they are called as a firm, and the name under which the business is carried on is called as a firm name. I think we have completed the introduction. In the next lecture, we will see the features of partnership firm, duties of partnership firm. I request all of you, if you have any questions, suggestions, please send me in the comment box so that I will improve myself and I will give you the quality lecture in the next episode. Thank you.